Welcome to lecture number 002, voltage follower and differential amplifier. Before discussing, we will see the recap of previous video. In previous video, we have discussed about some of the configuration of operational amplifier. In that open loop configuration, output swings between either plus V saturation or minus V saturation. Plus V saturation corresponding to the condition when V plus is greater than V minus, that means non-inverting voltage is greater than inverting voltage, or otherwise VD greater than 0. And similarly, minus V saturation corresponding to V plus less than V minus, or otherwise VD less than 0. Next configuration we have discussed about inverting mode configuration, in that we derived the output is equal to minus RF by R1 times V in. Here minus sign indicates that the output voltage is 180 degree phase shift of input voltage, and the amplified by the gain RF by R1 times. Similarly, the non-inverting mode configuration, output voltage is equal to 1 plus RF by R1 times V in. Here the output is in phase with the input, but it is amplified by the gain 1 plus RF by R1. Next we will see the voltage follower. Voltage follower is the modified version of non-inverting amplifier. In non-inverting configuration, if we replace feedback resistance by 0 and input resistance R1 by infinity, we will get output is equal to input. That means your output follows exactly input both in phase as well as magnitude. Let us draw the diagram for voltage follower by imposing this condition. The positive terminal is connected to input source with respect to ground like this. Inverting terminal is directly connected to the output without any feedback resistance. That's why it is called as unity feedback. This is your output V naught. You'll get V in. The voltage follower will offer low output impedance and high input impedance. This is a very important application used in impedance matching. Okay, let us see the what is meant by impedance match. Suppose if you want to connect high impedance source to low impedance load directly, if you do so, what will happen? Due to impedance mismatch, the maximum power will not transfer to the load. To avoid this condition, we need to connect one intermediate block, that is called buffer. Buffer will offer high impedance at the input and low impedance at the output. So your source demands high input impedance, that is satisfied by buffer input terminal, and your load demands low impedance, that is satisfied by output of your buffer. If you connect like this, the maximum power will transfer to the load via buffer. This is called impedance matching. So now we'll discuss next configuration of operational amplifier, is that differential amplifier. Next configuration of operational amplifier is the differential amplifier, or sometimes it is called as difference amplifier. It will amplify the difference between two input signal. Let us see the typical circuit for differential amplifier. There are two input signal, V1 and V2. Let us designate this resistance as R1, this also as R1, and let us designate this resistance as R2, similarly feedback resistance also R2. Now we will derive the output voltage. We are taking ideal amplifier. The condition is that the current drawn by inverting terminal and non-inverting input terminal both are 0, and one more assumption is that the potential difference across two input terminal is 0. Now let us label this node as A and this node as B. Analysis We'll go for analysis to solve output voltage equation. Let us label the current. This current is I1 and this current is I2 and this current is IF and this current is I3. Okay, that to find V0, the trick is that first you solve for non-inverting voltage by applying KCL at node B, then solve for V plus by applying KCL at node B gives sum of current entering into the node is I1 and sum of current leaving to from the node is I2. I1 is equal to V1 minus, let us designate this voltage as VB and this node voltage as VA. Okay, so I1 is equal to V1 minus VB by R1. V1 minus VB by R1. Similarly, I2 is equal to VB minus 0 by R2. VB minus 0 by R2. Segregating VB and V1, so we'll get VB is equal VB into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 is equal to V1 by R1. Next step, you take LCM, we'll get R1 plus R2 into R1 plus R2 by R1 into R2, it is equal to V1 by R1. R1 get cancelled. So from this we'll get VB is equal to R2 times V1 by R1 plus R2. Next, you apply KCL at node A gives, so current entering into the node is I2 and leaving from the node is IF. So I2 is equal to IF. So here I2 is equal to V2 minus VA by R1. V2 minus VA by R1 is equal to IF is equal to VA minus V0 by R2. VA minus V0 by R2 and we solve for VA. So if we segregate VA, we will get here 1 by, we bring this minus VA by R1 to right hand side, you will get 1 by R1 plus here already 1 by R2, it is equal to V2 by R1 plus V0 by R2. So from this, next you eliminate VA by the condition the VD is equal to 0. VD is nothing but VD is nothing but V plus minus V minus. V plus is nothing but VB minus. V minus is nothing but VA. The condition is equal to 0. So from this you will get VA is equal to VB. Now we replace VA by VB from this equation. So we will get R2 by R1 plus R2 into V1. By taking LCM of this term, we will get R1 plus R2 by R1 R2. So by cancelling this 2 and R2, so we'll get V1 by R1. So now you solve for V0. So the remaining term V1 by R1. Next you solve for V0. V0 by R2 is equal to, you bring this V2 by R1 to right hand side, you'll get V1 by R1 minus V2 by R1 you'll be getting. Okay, next you bring R2 to this side, then rearrange, you'll get R2 by R1 into V1 minus V2. So V1 is the input voltage applied at non-inverting input terminal, and V2 is the input voltage applied at inverting input terminal. See this output equation. The output, it is equal to the difference in voltage V1 minus V2, and it is amplified by the gain R2 by R1. That's why it is called as differential amplifier, or sometimes it is called as difference amplifier. The differential amplifier is the main circuit in instrumentation amplifier. Thank you for watching.